Well, sir, I didn't actually come by here to talk about work.
Yeah, I didn't think so.
Yeah.
So, is something bothering you?
You could always tell, couldn't you?
Well, I've known you since we were like two. And you are like my brother, even though you can be an annoying one sometimes. If you and Sarah go way back like you said, then I'm sure you wouldn't want to destroy her just to free up Casey for Meg.
Yeah, I guess that wouldn't be a kind thing to do from one old friend to another.
What is it? Tim, is this about Tess?
What do you say?
I don't know. I thought maybe something might have happened between you two.
No. Everything's fine.
Okay, because, you know, if anything did, you can talk to me. I know what it's like to have things go south in the romance department.
Oh, but not these days. I mean, you just moved in here, and Casey's totally devoted to you, and you got everything you want, right?
Yeah, but you can too. You know, I think it's about time that you got a break. You had it way too tough growing up. And losing Meg, I know how hard that was on you.
Yeah, you know something, you're right. I guess I am due.
Well, then just go for what you want. Stay positive and know that you deserve it.
And I know that Sarah and Casey deserve to be happy.
Yeah, they do.
But hey, so do we. And $1 million can make us very happy.
Oh, God, you're making this so hard. I just want to make the right decision. And what do you think we should do?
I don't know about you, but I'm sick of being on the outside and looking in.
I don't know, I guess the moral is just do whatever it takes, like Casey and I did. It'll pay off, big time.
Casey, hey, what's going on?
Hey, Brad, what's up?
I just wanted to talk to you about getting a day off.
Look, Brad, I just got this pizza, and I'm starving, so if you'll just excuse me, man, I gotta get inside.
You know, you just have to trust that if it's what you and Tess both want, it'll happen. You can have it all, Tim.
All right, Sarah, you've convinced me. Question is, can you?
Brad, I'd be happy to talk about the schedule tomorrow at work.
No, this, okay. Dude, this is only take a second.
No, come on, you gotta give me a break here. I'm trying to spend a nice, quiet evening at home with my girlfriend.
Oh. Right. Gotcha.
Tim, what are you talking about?
I think you know exactly what I'm talking about, Sarah.
No, I don't.
Sarah, your whole relationship with Casey was built on a lie, which means you guys really never had anything at all.
Okay, go. Get out now.
You know, I'm just wondering something. I want to know how long is it going to take before your whole house of cards comes crashing down?
Why are you doing this? Look, Casey and I are finally happy.
Yeah, for now. Wait until he finds out what a little lying schemer you are. And hey, I don't have to tell you how Mr. Integrity feels about lying, right?
Please keep your voice down. Casey will be here any minute now.
What about the time that you set Meg up out in Palm Springs, just hoping that she might walk in to see Ben and Maria together? Remember
Tim,
that?
Stop it!
What about the time you messed with Casey's car, just so he couldn't make it out there to see Meg? Just worried that your big sister might turn to your boyfriend in her time of need.
You know why I did that.
Yeah, I do know why, because you were paranoid of losing him to her. And you know something? I bet you're more paranoid right now about what he may think when he finds out.
Hey, Tim, I will do anything that you want. Just please don't tell Casey what I did to Meg. He's never going to understand that. Casey.
Casey, look, man. I'm sorry. We didn't know you were
there. Get out. Sorry. Get out. Sorry. Look.
Now.
Hey,
now.
What are you doing?
Now.
Your hands up. Sam!